Hey everybody, welcome back to Bottom Shelf Bar.
That's Connor.
That's Paul.
And Connor, what is this?
Well, this very smelly concoction is called...
very strong.
Baijiu. And it is the number one liquor in China, where they sell 5 billion liters of it per year. It's difficult to find in the U.S., but I was able to track some down. By sheer chance, I saw it, and I was like, all right, better get some.
we were at the liquor store for something else entirely.
Yeah, and I saw it, and I was like, we're going to have to do this. And it is actually bottom shelf this time. This bottle was $17, which for something imported is pretty reasonable.
It's true.
And I get the feeling this is not what you would call a high-end Baijiu.
Yeah, I'm sure that that's true. The smell is intense.
Yeah.
It's filling the room.
On the subject of the smell, one of the defining characteristics of Baijiu is its aroma. There are many different... that's how you refer to the, like, varieties of the spirit, as, like, by its aroma. I'm not completely sure what this aroma is called.
Don't smell that deep. That was a mistake.
It sure is strong.
I took a nose full of it, and oh boy. It's like, God, it's like almost like a, like licorice adjacent.
It's licorice adjacent, but there's something else to it.
Yeah.
But a shot is one of the most the most common way of doing this. It's kind of associated due to its reputation with, like, very heavy drinking. And also, like, weird cultural norms where young people are pressured to drink a lot more than they should. Which is dangerous because, I didn't mention this yet, this is 110 proof.
Yep, 55%.
So,
which
Yeah. We're gonna play it safe. relatively speaking.
This is as strong as the absinthe that we tried, and absinthe is known for its strength. And this is just what people just drink.
So, yeah, we're gonna... I guess we're just gonna send it.
Send it. God, the smell is so, so intensely strong. And I can't even necessarily say it's bad. It's just, it's not something I've encountered before. So I don't want to say because I don't want to be like ethnocentric, but...
I'm going to accuse you of stalling.
I am stalling.
It's time. Let's have shots.
Oh!
Holy shit.
Oh!
Oh no,
it tastes terrible. I'm sorry, it tastes terrible.
That finish is just like vomit.
Oh!
Oh! Yeah, you feel the proof. It tastes... It's got a weird sweetness to it.
Oh!
It's...
I am so sorry if I offend anyone, but this is vile. This tastes atrocious.
I don't suspect that we got a great example. But the back of my mouth and my throat is still burning.
Oh, God. That literally made me want to throw up. That was... Oh, my God. That wasn't on the proof. That was on the flavor alone. That was very rough.
Yeah. I wouldn't say it's good.
Yeah. It's like black licorice and sesame had a hate child.
That's more than I got from it.
Oh, God. That is rough, man.
Well, we shall continue to test it. Oh. But first, we're going to... like, thoroughly cleanse our palates and then play a game. Having taken a moment to compose ourselves, we are now just gonna spin quarters and see who can make it spin the longest.
It was a long moment. That stuff is intense.
It was... Ooh. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let it rip.
Oh!
Oh yeah, you got me beat. Oh! Conspicuously,
I feel like mine was still spinning when it fell.
All right,
this is what I used to do in like lunch in high school, like every day. I'm easily entertained just as a person.
Hey, you know, spinning quarters is pretty fun. We're gonna try to make a sour with this. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, it sure will be interesting. I guess
maybe. Okay, we've been stalling long enough now. This is a Baijiu sour. It is made like any sour. Two parts liquor, one part lemon juice, one part simple syrup. And it still smells.
The smell is nauseating.
It smells so bad.
This is maybe the biggest mistake we've ever made on the show.
Hey, but we do it so you don't have to. That's the whole thing.
Oh, right. Why'd I smell it? I knew what I was going to find.
Zebra stripes down the pipes. Oh, my God. Oh, it tastes even more like vomit.
It really does.
Oh no.
Oh, fuck.
That is a premonition I did not want to have. Oh. Oh, no.
Oh, no. It literally tastes like throw up. That is so bad.
I'm going to exercise my rights as a lightweight and veto this one.
Yeah. Yeah, me too. The mix of citrus and this, I'm going to be honest, just awful flavor is bad. It makes me want to die.
The additional acid and sweetness
literally makes it taste like vomit.
It just tastes like vomit.
Oh god, that was ugh.
Alright.
Woo!
Yeah. You probably remember if you've seen some of our older episodes, we don't do this often, if ever.
I think there's one other time where we were like, we're not drinking this. And yeah. I don't even remember what it was.
I'm not
having another taste of this. It is so similar to vomit, I'm worried I'm going to.
Yeah.
This is bad.
So, for the sake of our stomachs and my kitchen, we're going to just fast forward to the game. Truly, there's no quarter given tonight. But now, we're going to spin some quarters.
The smell is so bad. It's starting to make me, like, congested. Like, I think my nose is trying to shut it down.
3, 2, 1, spin! God, you beat you. I think you got me again.
I got them strong fingers.
Yeah. Alright. Paul wins.
Nice.
Now
for a mistake.
Yeah, we're gonna make a cocktail I found on the internet. Alright, this is called a Golden River. I found it on a Baijiu cocktails website. It is made with specifically they tell you to use a strong aroma Baijiu, then some Lillet Blanc, triple sec, and a bar spoon of Amaro. They recommend Fernet Branca.
We used Amaretto because we had a gap in communication.
Yeah, we messed up. And then you are supposed to float some foam from beer on top. We tried to do that, but
it went away.
The beer I have is Old Milwaukee and it sucks, so the head went away.
Yeah, but there was a head on it for a brief moment in time.
So now,
let me just tell you, I shook this cocktail, you know, sans the beer foam, and it is one of the worst things I've ever smelled in my entire life. Oh boy, I'm scared.
We're gonna drink it now. Smell at least some of it.
This is meant to be a cocktail that people would sit and enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't believe anyone would sit and enjoy this at all.
Ever. Well, not with this Baijiu, probably.
Oh, this smells so bad.
It's better. Oh, never mind. Nope, still tastes like vomit. But now there's some beer.
It's worse. It's worse. It's so much worse.
The aftertaste is the worst part.
Oh.
Oh my.
Oh my god, this is worse. This is definitely worse.
This is vile. I'm gonna go in for another and I'm gonna regret it, but for the content, baby.
I feel like I've thrown up at this point.
Oh no, yeah. No, that is just straight up vomit taste.
Oh boy.
Okay, we're done. We're done here.
Oh my god. This is... Look, I'm going to be honest with you. Especially with alcohol.
I'm going to get some water. I'll be right back.
It's so bad. Fucking shit. You have mouthwash?
I have an extra toothbrush if you want to brush your teeth. But I don't have mouthwash.
Unironically, I might take you up on that. I'm dying.
So we're gonna brush our teeth real quick.
Wait, we still have to do the last call.
Whoo! Okay, we've returned from brushing our teeth.
And spraying everything with Febreze.
Yeah.
The smell of this stuff is so strong, and it just tastes like literal vomit.
We're gonna spin the quarters.
This is gonna be the worst last call in the history of the show, without a doubt.
Alright. 3, 2, 1, go. No need to stall, we haven't even made it yet.
I know.
Got me again.
Strong fingers, man. They got the muscles.
Well, you do need muscles to be strong.
We're gonna make a last call, and we're gonna regret it.
Yeah. Out of every last call we've ever done, I think this is the one we are most scared of by far.
Yeah, this is probably gonna be one of the worst things either of us have ever tasted. We are going to try to chug the entire thing, as is tradition. This last call has 1 ounce of Rabbit Hole Bespoke Gin from last episode, which is very good and does not deserve this treatment. 1 ounce of Lillet Blanc, 1 ounce of Dolan Blanc Sweet Vermouth, 1 ounce of lemon juice, 1 ounce of simple syrup, 1 ounce of Triple Sec, 1 ounce of...
Amaretto.
1/2 ounce of amaretto.
1/2 ounce amaretto.
Which really we should have done a bar spoon, but anything to help to mask the flavor of the 1 ounce of this. Oh, I'm so worried about this. And then orange and lavender bitters. And we tried to do the beer foam floater again, but it dissolved. As well as the cocktail blueberries I'd prepared.
Yes. So the Shifeng Joe gets one last chance to shine, and I'm sure it will not make the most of it. So yeah, let's do it. Cheers.
If I die, tell my mom I love her. Oh, the smell.
BRB. So yeah.
We needed a break after that.
Yeah, you probably saw it. I don't know how much of that's gonna be in the final cut, but ooh, it was bad.
It was. I'm shell shocked.
We
had those lemon slices just to try to clear our palates immediately, and it didn't help
it
as much as I wanted.
No. We're gonna spin the quarters, and then you'll be unsurprised to find out what our scores are. 3, 2, 1, go. There we go. To a degree, it is a hazing ritual.
All right, well, it fell off the table,
I'll take the win. yeah, Shifeng Zhou, as far as Baijiu goes, I guess if you're, like, in the States and you just really, really want to try some, this is maybe one of your only options, but I just wouldn't.
Yeah, I think this is one of those things where you can just be contented to sit at home and know that you don't ever need to experience what this is like.
Yeah, there were things that maybe tasted like something other than vomit in there, but, like, for the most part, it was just pain.
Just tasted like straight vomit, especially with any citrus added. Terrible.
Yeah, everything we added made matters worse. So, yeah, I think it's safe to say we're giving this a 0 out of 5.
0 out of 5. Easy. Easiest rating.
It may have only been $17, but it is just not worth... It's not worth it.
I would rather take a shot of Everclear than another shot of this stuff.
Yeah. This is only good for hazing, basically. it looks relatively innocuous, but it is in fact very innocuous.
And you know, I assume there's a certain amount of this that's like cultural palates or something like that. Because I assume if this is the single most drank spirit in China, people enjoy the taste. So some of this has to literally be like the environment, but I literally couldn't stomach another taste of this. I would rather see the rest of this used as fuel to start a fire than
drink. Yeah, we're we're done here. This has been Bottom Shelf Bar. I'm Connor.
I'm Paul.
And we'll see you in the next episode. As always, let us know if you want us to try anything down below.
As long as it's not this, apparently.
Yeah, we won't do any more of these for a while, probably. yeah. Peace out.
Oh, man. Oh, my God. We have to make everyone we know try a shot of this stuff.